Well, around Northern California, people are cleaning up after this weekend storm system. Dan Shively has been touring all the damage in Live Cop 3 HD. Dan, what have you seen from up above?
Well, we've seen a lot of repair work going on, and this is one of the more interesting ones. We are up in Sutter County, right by the town of East Nicholas, actually, you know, between Sacramento and Marysville, Yuba City. You can see it's out in the middle of a field. There was a steel transmission line that was blown down the other day, and now PG&E crews are out trying to restore that line, and they have a big challenge in front of them. First of all, it is extremely muddy down there, and they can't put a new steel tower up right away, so they are using a couple of wooden towers, kind of like telephone poles, as temporary. And you can see a strange vehicle driving up there into your screen right now. Boy, they've got all this bizarre equipment used for special purposes, and apparently that's used to get through muddy fields because they can't get a regular truck out there because it's just too sloppy. But we've been seeing vehicles like that. And up on the towers themselves, if Ron Middlecoff's our photographer, Ron, if you can widen up out and just tilt up a little bit, they are getting supplied right now by helicopter. There's a helicopter hovering overhead delivering the supplies to the men on the poles. And not only that, that's how the men got on the poles. They were riding on the bottom of a line, taken right out to the top of the pole. So it's a real tricky maneuver, both for the helicopter pilot and for the PG&E crew members that are down there working on it right now. So I don't know what the time frame is to get this done, but obviously it's a major transmission line, and they want to restore power as quickly as possible. And, boy, they're pulling out all the stops in order to do it. That's the situation from up here between Sacramento and Marysville for right now, Walt.
Wow, dramatic pictures there, Dan, and it's amazing what kind of tread you actually need to get around to some of these rural poles.
Boy, you know, PG&E just has it all figured out, I think. In fact, already we came up here looking for a downed power line, power pole, and the whole tower's already been disassembled and carted away, and they've already installed the two temporary wooden poles and are now in the process of probably stringing the cable, the wire back up there to get that power restored. But as I say, it's very tricky both in the air and on the pole itself. Take a look at that.
Yeah, do tell. Okay, Dan Shively and photographer Ron Middlecoff, Live Cop 3 HD. Great pictures for the early afternoon.